You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. Every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual.
The moment that you speak, I wanna run and play, hide and seek.
Wanna go and bounce the moon, just like a big toy balloon. Because
you and I, we are just like a couple of cats.
Welcome to Standard Man Production. You know, I go down to a gym and I met a man, 82 years old, and talk, and we enjoyed one another's conversation. Well, I found out that this guy had a kid show in Cincinnati, Ohio, every day, Monday through Friday, and like Captain Kangaroo. But anyway, I want to welcome you to see today how Billy, Banjo Billy, is doing.
I'm gonna feel the way I do this here day, because
you make me feel so young. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung.
Every time I see you grin,
I'm such a cuckoo individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna run and play hide and seek.
Like to go and bounce the moon, like a big fat balloon.
Because you and I,
we're gonna have to cut into the Cartoon Network there, because Banjo Billy just showed up. And ladies and gentlemen, it's Banjo Billy. Well, welcome to the Banjo Billy Show, and we're live in New York. So, what was we today?
Well, we were at the gym today.
Yes, and when I was at the gym, I turned to you,
and
I says, Bill, I see a lot of machines out on the floor here, you know, a lot of equipment. What equipment should I use on the floor here to pick up the chicks?
Pick up chicks? Well, the best piece of equipment I can think of to pick up chicks is out in the hall.
What machine is that?
The ATM.
You got it right, Bill. I tell you what.
He fed me that line.
Well, anyway, we're going to go to a short cartoon right now for all you kids out there, because you know who... Hey, let me tell you, talk about chicks. You know who was one of my favorite chicks back in the day?
No, who?
Cartoons. Who was your favorite cartoon chick?
My favorite cartoon chick?
Yes.
Well, I guess Olive Oil.
Oh, come on, that skinny... She was kind of thin, wasn't she? Betty Boop with the big head and the small feet. You know,
I remember Betty Boop, too.
Betty Boop.
Yeah.
Boop, boop, ba-doop. Well, anyway, here we come with a Betty Boop cartoon. So everybody back out there... And at the Billy Banjo Show, sit back and enjoy Betty!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a brand new adventure starring the ever-glorious Miss Betty Boop, that singing and dancing ray of cartoon sunshine. When last we saw Betty, she was always getting into trouble, always getting out of trouble, and always getting into it again. Join us now as our plucky heroine, together with her trusty pals Coco the Clown and Bimbo the Musical Dog, take on the wild and wonderful world of Hollywood, where anything can happen and usually does.
and keep the nickel for a tip.
Cheapskate.
Uh-oh. Hiya, doll.
You're late, Mr. Slade. We better be able to count on you tonight.
Yeah, but first let me get a cup of Java, okay? Hey, how's about some service over here?
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, where's mine? Yeah.
Where's my burger?
Where's my eggs?
Where's that waitress with them pretty legs?
Betty! 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 Betty!
Betty Boop, at your service.
Yay, Betty!
Here's your water, Elmo. Want a straw? That slice big enough for you, Jack? Don't eat so fast. How's about them cling peaches? Yum, yum.
That Betty Boop is really sweet.
You know, her singing is really neat.
Yeah, but when's it gonna put her on Easy Street?
Here's your cup of coffee, mister.
Hey, let's have more sales. And less service. Where's them plates?
Take it, Coco.
Speed it up. And watch the grill for me.
Oh, no! We need more eggs, Coco. Whoa! Cover for us, Betty!
South Pacific, in an equatorial clime, there's a beautiful isle where movie stars while away their leisure time. On Movie Star Island, the movie stars play. They lie on the beach and drink coolers all day. Each night there's a luau, and that's where they dine.
Remember, Mr. Slade, I'm counting on you.
Sure, I'll take care of everything. You know, that waitress and her pals are pretty entertaining.
Sorry, I can't stay to watch the show.
This ain't no dance hall. It's a diner.
Now what do we do? That's the third time this month we've been fired.
Cheer up, Bimbo. We'll find another job.
Yeah, but as musicians?
We are musicians, and nothing's gonna change that. Besides, I got this feeling our big break is right around the corner.
You're right about that, kid. I've been looking for some musicians to help me out on a surveillance job tonight.
Then you're a detective?
Sam Slade, best detective in town. You know, I was just having lunch with my client, a certain Miss Green. She's a personal secretary to Lola DeVille.
Ooh, the big Hollywood movie star?
The very same. Anyway, this Lola DeVille is wearing a $1 million diamond necklace at a costume party tonight. And she wants undercover protection. So she sent Miss Green to hire me. But the job's too big for just one gumshoe. And you being musicians, well, that's the perfect cover.
You mean like musical detectives?
What do you say?
Well, we don't know much about detecting, but we could surely find out. Right, boys?
Swell! Tonight at the DeVille Mansion, 8 o'clock.
Well, what are y'all staring at? Eat!
Mm-hmm.